Hey everyone, and welcome to this week's Tips and Tricks video. In this lesson, we're going to be learning how to take this asset here from Maya and get it into UDK with all of the materials and textures hooked up. So to start, what we're going to do is just go ahead and look at this object. Now, what we've got here is we've got an object that is kind of out in space, and its pivot point is over here off to the side. Now, a few things that we're going to need to do to start is to kind of center this pivot point on the object and also place it at the origin. So there are a few ways we can do this. If we want to move the pivot of the object, if you hit the insert key, you'll see that it kind of changes your transform tool here, and you can go ahead and move the pivot without moving the object. Now if we wanted to, let's say, go in the front view and align the pivot this way, let's say we wanted it at the handle, and then maybe go in the top view, maybe go in the top view and align it that way. That would be one way we could do it. But another way we can do it is, if we want to, we can just go ahead and go up to Modify and click Center Pivot. And what that's going to do is that's just going to automatically center the pivot at the object. Now let's say, maybe since this is a gun, we wouldn't want the pivot here, so I'm just going to go ahead and actually move the pivot to the handle. But it's at least important to know that there are multiple ways you can move the pivot here. So from here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to then move this object to the origin. So if I go back into my perspective view, the easiest way to do that is to just kind of hold the X key, and this is going to allow you to snap to the grid. So I'm just going to go ahead and snap this to the grid. And then as one final step inside of my here before we export, is I'm just going to go ahead and make sure these translate values are set to zero, or essentially that the transforms are frozen. So if I go to Modify, Freeze Transforms, you'll see that's going to set everything to zero but still preserve the location of this. So I'm just going to go ahead and save this file. And then from here what we can do is go ahead and export it. So I'm going to go to File, Export All. And then under FBX, I'm going to choose the FBX exported from the drop-down here. It gets a little cut off by the recording resolution. But I'm going to go ahead and click Pistol. I just kind of had a file here existing already. And then what I'm going to want to make sure I do is turn off Embed Media, because we're going to actually be hooking up the textures and importing them manually inside of UDK. So from here, if I just go ahead and click Export All, ask me if I want to overwrite it. Of course I do. And now we can actually go into UDK and begin to import it. So here we are inside of UDK. I've got my content browser over here. And to start importing, what we're going to do is just bring in the mesh. So I'm just going to click Import, go to my desktop, and find the location of this file. Export. We've got our pistol FBX right here. I'm going to create a package called Pistol. And under Group, just for the organization of this, I'm just going to name it Mesh. And under these options here, make sure that we don't have like import materials or textures checked or anything. It shouldn't bring them in anyway, since we didn't embed the media, but just make sure that those are not checked. And if I just click OK, what we'll see is now into this browser, we've got a little thumbnail. And if we double click it, let me resize this window, we've got our mesh here. But as we can tell, it has no textures yet. So what I'm going to do is just close this down, and I'm going to click Import again. And then in the textures folder here, I've got a few textures. I've got a diffuse, an emissive, I've got my normal map, and my specular. Now, I'm going to go ahead and import everything except the normal map, and that's because the normal map requires a different type of compression. So if I just select these three, click Open, and again, just to keep things organized, I'm going to create a grouping called Textures. And everything else here should be fine. I'm just going to click OK to all, and then this is going to go ahead and import all of the textures. Okay, so now we've got these textures imported. Now what I have to do is go ahead and do that process again for the normal map. And then we can keep everything here the same. We want to keep them the same grouping and everything, but the only thing we're going to change is under compression settings, is set that to normal map, and then just click OK, and then that's going to go ahead and import the normal map. Okay, so as you can see, we've got all our textures in here now. If we go back to our actual package, or the base level of the package, you'll see that we've got everything here. We've got our static mesh and our four textures. So from here, what we're going to need to do is go ahead and create a new material. And we can do that by right-clicking, and then up here, just click New Material. And then name this material. And then I'll just say pistol material. And then just click OK. Go ahead and resize this here. So inside this dialog here, what we've got is we've got a preview window of the mesh. We've got a actually it's kind of not lit right now, but we're not going to worry about that too much. We can do everything we need to here inside of just this little window right here. And we've got all of these kind of nodes that we can add or material functions. So what we're going to want to do to start is go and find the texture sample node. And you can do that just by searching here. And we find texture sample. If we drag this over here, what this is basically going to do is give us a blank texture sample. And under here, under the texture node, what we can do is we can begin to hook up all of the textures that we brought in. So if I go back to my package, and let's say I click on the diffuse, which is the underscore D, and I just go ahead and import that here, we'll see that we now have that texture inside that texture sample, and we can go ahead and, as expected, kind of take this little black box and hook it up into the diffuse, and we'll see that we now have a texture that's going to show up here. So next what we can do is just go ahead and do this for the rest of them. If we want to, let's say, stay organized, I can just click this once and hold down Control and move these nodes. Now another way to bring in this texture sample node is if I, let's say, select the actual texture here, and I click back here over in this window and hold down T and click, it's going to bring in a texture sample node, but it's already going to have the pistol emissive, or basically whatever texture you have selected, assigned to it. So I'm just going to go ahead, since I already have this here, that's the emissive, I'm going to hook that up. I'm going to do the same for the normal map. Hold down T and click and hook that into normal. I'm just going to zoom out a little bit here so you can see. And for the very last one, which is the specular, I'm just going to go ahead again and click T, or hold T and click, and then drag that little black box over into specular. So what this does is it actually completes the material, or at least the base level material, none of the edits that we would possibly want to make, which is, I'd say, is good enough for this example. And we can go ahead and close this down and apply the changes. Just click yes. So the last thing that we need to do here in order to get the actual material hooked up is if we go ahead and double click our actual mesh. UDK is probably doing some auto-saving right now. Okay, there we go. So under here is, now that we've got this open, if we unroll the LOD info, we're going to have quite a few. I'm going to just kind of re-roll these up so we can see it as we unroll it. So we've got our elements here, and then under the material it's set to none. And then under the material channel here, if we just go ahead and find our material inside of our package, and then just hook that up in there, we'll see that we now have our material on our gun, which is exactly what we needed. So, all right, well, that kind of concludes this lesson. Thanks again for watching 3dmotive.com.